Hi guys, welcome to the unboxing and full review of this DFG smartwatch with HRV, heart rate variety or variation, activity tracker, blood oxygen meter, heart rate, blood pressure monitor, and so on. Looks like it has a lot of measuring capabilities, and it's listed for around $53 on Amazon currently. For some reason, it says there's no brand name for this watch. I don't know why, brand unknown. It's sold currently by DFG, but I'm going to take the thing out of the box so you see what you get, and then I'm going to test this for a couple of days and I'm going to show you how this thing works and also the app. So here it says GT2, at least we have something like a model type or so, maybe same thing. Model GT2. There's not much, it will be difficult to find maybe online. I would say standard box, nothing special, didn't come even sealed or so, not even a sticker, no nothing. But I think it looks rather new. GT2 quick guide, there's even contact information, email contact, that's good, but it looks like there's no website. So I'm going to show you the full manual, which is just a couple of pages. Maybe it could be worth to show you that. So I try to focus a little bit better. I hope you can see everything. If you go to the highest resolution, usually 1080p, put it in pause on every page, so you should have enough time to read everything. So I'm showing you 2 pages by 2 pages here. It's not much, but we are already close to halfway. Maybe it's even everything if there's Chinese on the back. No, looks like everything is English, so pretty detailed information. That's good. We are getting close to the end. Different sports mode, countdown, reminder function, and that's it here. Customer service again. When I look at the email address, watch Wofit, maybe we can find something with Wofit if you need more information. So here is how it looks in the box. Let's try to find a way to get it out. Looks like the watch band is separate, but the good thing is that we can buy separate watch bands. Looks like it's standard. What we have to be careful about is that here, I wouldn't say new style, we have seen this a lot, but you have to be really careful with this thing here. When we have the mount of this watch band here integrated in the watch, not like with separate brackets, then usually there's some limited space here inside of the housing. I hope you can see that. Maybe it's focusing a little bit so you can see that. There's a limited space here inside, and if you buy a watch band which is too thick, a lot of these watch bands are rather thick here in this area. If you want to mount something, maybe then it's not working. You have to make sure that you buy watch band which is also pretty thin here, but it looks actually pretty good. We have also this pin here which secures it in place. No, we don't have it. That's maybe something to consider. You can see here there's no pin inside which holds it in place. We have this thing here which maybe helps a little bit to keep this thing, this strap here in place. We'll see over time. And we get of course the proprietary charging cable which is a magnet. Let's see how good this works. It's on the side, that's rather unusual, but it's strong. Not super strong, but I would say strong enough, nothing weird. Then we see the LEDs here, really nice or really interesting. 2 green ones, 2 white ones, 1 transparent one, and we have this metal plate here which usually works for some heart detection, heart rate variation or even ECG. Usually we don't need this metal thing just for heart rate variability check. Usually these things are only used for real ECG, I mean electrocardiogram. So I'll have to find out what we really have here. What's rather weird is that we have this sensor here. So usually it makes contact on your wrist, and then the whole current goes through your body and your arm when you're touching here. So you have to make sure that this button is not touching your skin, otherwise it won't work. This is a rather unusual, I would say, construction. Usually we have the other metal maybe on top or something like that, not on the side. So you have to be really careful with that. So I'm going to charge it and then set up with the app. So I'm charging it now. It's charging only with 0.2 amps, but this is pretty much standard for a smartwatch. Then I have been scanning the QR code here. It brought me to the official Android web store or Android Play store, which is really good. The thing is, it doesn't have the best reviews, but sometimes these apps are working for different watches, so maybe then the bad reviews here are for just for the app or even for other watches. These bad reviews don't really have to be related to this watch, so I'm not too worried about that. Of course, then you have to give all the permissions and so on. This is pretty much standard. Then you have two versions, registered and light versions. And sometimes with the light versions, we have some limited functionality like watch faces and so on. And so I recommend, if you want to plan to use this for a longer time, I recommend to register. You also have usually the advantage that they are storing your data. I mean, it's not very private data. I mean, it's your blood pressure and heart rate and those things. So what can they do with that? And when you have to set up your account, let's say on another smartphone, when you buy a new smartphone, and then you can use your credentials, log in again, and you will probably find, or most likely find, your old data. So this is usually the thing which I'm choosing. Yeah, what's important here to get notification, of course, this thing here is read notification permission. You have to turn this on here. I think that's the one here. Then we have to go to the WoFit and turn this thing on, and then we can go back and probably we can select the things we have to do, or not, select notifications from the app. There are more notifications. Just read everything and then apply the notification or like permissions as needed. I've been giving all the authorizations, but it's somehow weird. I never seen such complicated authorizations here. But now, yeah, let's. I think we are ready here to connect the watch. So let's click on top here, add new device, and GT2. Yeah, okay, looks good. 95% charged. Yeah, okay. Pairing, WoFit is running. Yeah, looks everything good. Now I think I'm more or less ready to really use it. And so I'm going to wear it now for a couple of days and let you know how it turned out. So I'm here after wearing this watch for about 48 hours, and this is how the battery, or how long the battery lasted. Yeah, I had to recharge the battery this morning, so yeah, it was around, I would say, 44 hours or so, not even 2 full days, but I had activated everything. But this is a rather watch which you have to recharge every day if you are planning to use all the functions, but it has a lot of functions. I mean, it's probably the watch which has the most functions I've ever seen. This is crazy, at least regarding the health and fitness functionality. I won't be able to cover everything what I have seen so far during these 2 days within this half hour, which I'm usually using for such reviews maximum. But I'm trying to show you as much as possible. Regarding the watch faces, yeah, it has been very disappointing here. We just have a couple of them, and they are very similar. So there are no very bright ones, dark ones, or so, which you could use during the night, because there's also a problem regarding the brightness. I'm going to show you that later, but you can see there's not much variation. But at least most of them are showing the day, date, time, battery connectivity, those things. So you get most of the information. What's bad when you are in a certain setting? Yeah, not here, but let's say we are here. And then you get into timeout. You want to do something. You have maybe 5 seconds timeout. And then you have to click again to activate this. You cannot just touch to wake. It won't wake up just by touching. You have to push this button here. That's the only real button here. And then it goes back to into the main menu. That's a bad thing. Yeah, the watch face is definitely not a really good thing. I hope they will come up with more. And usually you have to long press and then change the watch face. It's not here. Here you have to go up and down. This is really weird. This is very uncommon, unusual. They should change that. I mean, usually we have a status menu to pull down. That's not available. There's just no status menu. I mean, there's a lot of things missing, like the some information, maybe a do not disturb or activate, deactivate the wrist gesture, or using this as a torch during the night, those things, or flashlight during the night. Usually you have many things in the status menu, but there's no status menu. Or sometimes you have the status menu down and then you have the info up, like all the messages which you get, that's not here. This is really an uncommon menu here. I mean, you will get used to that, but if you know like standard watch menu, then it's a little bit difficult. And sometimes it's a little bit difficult to also to use, because let's say you want to get or see the information which you got, you have to go left and then you have to go down, and then there's the information here, like information which you got as notification from the smartphone, like from WhatsApp, SMS and those things. And I think that's even just the latest one, and everything's gone. There's no delete. So this is really, really, really bad. I mean, I'm not saying it's a bad watch. It has great features, but some things are really not so good. So again, we have on the left side, we have these menus here. I think it starts. Yeah, let's go back and go to left side. So it starts with the sports modes. It has quite some different sports modes, you can see. But it doesn't have a history. Sometimes we have a history here on the watch. That's not the case here. So we can start it. When we click on it, it starts immediately. We also see a current time, which is good. It's very small, but at least it's here. But the good thing, there's also one good thing, and that's really a unique thing and really, really rare. When you have started this sport thing, you can go back to the main screen and use other functions. You click here, you can see that you go to the main screen and you can do other things. I mean, yeah, no, actually you can't do other things, but at least you can see the main screen, which is helpful to see the current time. Then whatever you do, yeah, it goes back into sports mode. Okay, but this is really good. And then you, when you go down, you have even more information you can see. I mean, you have the heart rate, you have the calories burned, you have steps, distance, pace, a lot of thing. I don't know why they are using this pace, but yeah, maybe it's a common thing, I don't know. And then you can pause or end this thing here and you get some statistics. Pretty nice. Yeah, not bad. I can't go back. It's really weird. Yeah. But it has been working pretty good, except from the heart rate. Heart rate, I'm not a big fan of the heart rate here, but let's go into that later. Here we have the ECG, which is really an electrocardiogram. We can invoke this here, but I'm not sure if it's really doing a full ECG test. By the way, there's two sensors we have to touch with one arm, or with one finger of one hand of one arm here, and with the other finger of the other hand, with the, of the other arm, this one here. So you have to really make sure that this current, I mean, there's somewhere current going out and on the other side it's going in, that it makes the full circle around and then you through the body and then into your other finger. So what I advise is not to hold it like this, because it's really difficult not to touch here, because otherwise it creates some kind of short circuit. This is really bad design. It's so close here. I don't know if you can see that. It's so freaking close. It's almost impossible to touch here and not to touch this hand. So if you are using that, what I recommend is to do something like that and then hold it maybe like this, something like that. So you will definitely avoid then touching the other side. So maybe, yeah, it's maybe better like this. I hope you can see that. You really have to make sure that it's not creating any kind of short circuit. I mean, there are many, many options which you can use. Now you can see we have the pulse or the heart rate, and it's not measuring through the light. I'm just holding here in the back this metal sensor. It's measuring really through a total different way, but I think it's not doing a full ECG. And we want to have a full ECG, we have to do it from the phone. So we have it here, I think the ECG, that's what we need to do here, testing, and then we have to hold like this. Don't make sure that it's not touching each other. I think on the watch you won't see anything. Just make sure, I think I have to start here with my small finger here, and you can see hopefully that I'm not touching here somewhere in between. Just one hand, one button, the other hand, the other one button, and now it gets some kind of measurement. It takes about 1 minute. You have to be really patient. Just make sure you do not do any crazy things. Don't do a YouTube video like me. That's definitely too much, but you can still see it's now measuring my heartbeat really nicely. So we're getting to the end of the measurement. Test finished. We click on save. And it says normal detection. I think that's it here. I mean, you can replay the whole thing from here. It will show everything what it has been measuring. It says normal detection when everything is normal. I think that's it here. There's not more, but I'll show you much more about heart detection, those things. But this is regarding ECG. ECG is a big problem these days because I think there has been some open source thing, but probably it was stolen from somebody, and then they did some claim on that, and now it's not available anymore, detailed ECG for free or so, but still we have it here. But let's go back to the watch. Heart rate, it's just a measurement, there's no statistics here. Then the blood pressure, same thing. Then the stopwatch, you can start, stop. The good thing is that we have some multitasking. You can go to the main screen and then go back to the stopwatch, so we can start, stop, reset, go back. Then countdown, exactly same thing. We can increase, decrease, hours, minutes, seconds, then start, reset, pause. And the good thing, we can really go back to the main screen, see the time and everything, and then go back to the countdown. We can even do other things, how it looks like, pause, reset, back. The information, again, that's not much. That's just some weather information which I got. There's no real weather information here. The SpO2, same thing. A quick measurement here on the watch. Control music from the watch. When you want to play something like YouTube video or so, music on your phone, you can control it. Find your phone. Yeah, you can hear that. Okay, it's not very loud, but at least it does it. I hope it will stop. Then the settings, information. Now that's the thing here that's really, really unique. You can set, or I mean activate or deactivate, all the information from here, directly from here. You can even go to, you can activate, deactivate, let's say from Instagram, and you can go to other, I think, I'm not sure if you can do, others you can just activate or deactivate. On the phone you have much more choice here. Then brightness, that's a big problem, even on the lowest setting. I mean, I'm here on the lowest setting and still super bright. There's no need to go to the level 12. I have it day and night on level 1, and it's in during the night on level 1, it's still way too bright. There's no automatic brightness as well. Automatic lock, you can choose between, I think, 6 seconds and 30 seconds. Yeah, here's the lowest thing, that's 3 seconds. For the video, of course, I'm going to the longest. There's not more we can do. And then the switch, everything which you want to turn on. So you can see there's a notification here. So you can turn on or off the alarms. I mean, you cannot change the alarm times or something like that, but if you notice, let's say in the middle of the night, oh, there's an alarm for the morning, and it's not needed, you can turn it off. At least that's something. Sedentary reminder, then we can turn on and turn off wrist gesture. But here, I mean, this setting belongs into a status menu and not here, but at least we have it. Pulse rate monitoring 24/7, SpO2 monitoring 24/7. Then the rate alarm during the night, you can activate, deactivate blood pressure monitoring 24/7. That's really, really cool. So you can see you can do a lot already here, but not everything. It's not perfect, but still you can see some things, and you have also some information about what you are doing during the day here directly on the watch, and you can turn it off as well. So let's go to the phone. So the app is a little bit complicated. I mean, it has huge, huge amount of information here, but it's also a little bit difficult. So the menu is actually on the left top. We have a today, we have an exercise, we have setting, we have family for sharing here if you want to share your information with other people. As basic settings here, it starts with some you can also do the measurements directly from here, heart rate measurement and so on. Then the device, you see some basic information, notification. Yeah, that's the thing here. You can see you have almost everything which you can turn on. I mean, a lot already here, but you have much more. You can click on other apps and it will list all the apps which you have on the phone, and you can activate or deactivate notification from everything. It hasn't been doing much. I mean, I had a lot of these things turned on and yeah, didn't get much information. Maybe need some time to get used to that. I don't know. I mean, the most important information like SMS, WhatsApp and so on, I got this information here. Then you can set HR scope, sedentary reminder. Then the wrist gesture, you can also set here. Brightness duration, you can also set here. Then the alarms. The good thing, you can do more than four alarms. Event reminder, you can set an event reminder, additional thing like an alarm, but for another day. Rotate, twist, take photo. Then you can adjust the blood pressure. If you come from a doctor or so, you have your reference values, you can enter them here. Switch settings, same thing as with the watch here. Firmware upgrade and so on. Clear device data, cancel pairing. Yeah, definitely not needed at the moment. Then we have some goals, units, app, language. Yeah, many languages you can see which you can choose. Connect to third-party platform, that's just Google available. I mean, Google Fit. Then we have the exercise. We can start exercise from here or of course from the watch, but everything which we have been recording, we can see also here, show all, and then we can go into details. And that's again, I mean, you can see, I mean, I've been starting here, and the heart rate should be the lowest, not here, but actually here, and then it should go up. I mean, doesn't look too promising. And we go to the next thing, should go up. Yeah, this just doesn't look like normal thing which I've been measuring like from other watches. This looks more like natural. So I'm not very convinced about the heart rate detection, I can tell you. Yeah, I mean, I've definitely seen more better ones. Then let's go to the today. That's the basic, that's main information here about everything, like the sleep, but the sleep is just as good as every other watch. Usually these things fail completely. They just measure if you're moving during the night or not. The heart rate, it will measure every minute, but it's not showing here. But you have like a range, but it's very difficult to see. You have so much information here, it's insane. This is much more than what I can show you here. I could show for hours things, I think. It's insane what we have here. How many information here about the blood pressure, all day blood pressure, then heart rate variation, which is monitored during the night, every night. And then we have the reference plot here and the analysis, how it's looking, if it's looking good or bad with the stars. Really nice thing here, a lot of information. You get also a number, 75, looks I'm in the green here. The SpO2, that's crazy here, that's a crazy thing here. Maybe it's even doing more than the Apple Watch. I don't know how much Apple can do, but this is crazy. You have the apnea time, you have the hypoxia time, you can see how much SpO2 you have on average during the night, respiratory rate, cardiac load, sleep activity, and so on. This is almost endless what you can see. And here again, the ECG weight you would have to enter manually, but it's crazy what you have. I've never seen this here, especially SpO2. This is insane what you have. And you have even this hypoxia wake up, so if your blood oxygen level drops too much during the night, like when you're snoring, it can wake you up. I mean, as you can see, I had 0 and 0, so it didn't have to do anything. But this could be an absolute lifesaver if you are affected by these things, apnea and hypoxia. This could be a lifesaver for you. I mean, it's just around $50. This is insane what this watch is doing. I'm not saying it's perfect. I mean, it doesn't have a wireless charge, doesn't have an always on display, doesn't have automatic brightness setting, doesn't have microphone and speak and those things. But it has really a lot. It has a lot in special regarding health monitoring and fitness. It's insane, especially regarding this SpO2. I mean, the, just recently the Vice watch came out and they were claiming they have something like that. And they were not even talking about hypoxia wake up, just monitoring a little bit. And everybody was freaking out and thinking how good this is. And they have even this wake up function. Nobody knows about that. This is insane. I mean, this could be something for almost everybody. And now the watch is here. You can buy it. $50. And I'll put down the link to the Amazon listing down into the description so you can check it out. Order it right from there if you like it. And I hope I've been able to help you a little bit with this video. If you have any questions or comments, just write to the comment section below. And I'm always happy to talk about these things. And if you like the video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.